Hello everyone, today we are going to learn some more input types in HTML. First, the form. The form tag is most used to create form or forms, but I have already explained it in the last video. Now, label, I've already explained, it's just like a title. The label, choose one of the colors. We are going to use SelectOption input type. So we put select. The select must have a name for manipulate the data after the user send it. So we can put colors. No, just color, because you can only choose one, so one color. ID color as well. Enter. Save it. We are going to our live server. Okay, let's just put a BR. Okay, so we choose one of the colors. We don't have any option yet, but we have our select. So option here, the first option will be null. Why? Because you may want to put something like this, choose one color, save it, and we have the text, choose one color. But now we want to have more options, like red, you put the value red of course, and blue, you put the value blue. Why do you want to have the value blue? We can have just B, or just BL, but blue is easier to understand. Now we have our choose one color, red and blue, but there's a problem. If we click red, we can choose one color again, go to the first option, but we don't want that. So what we do, we put disabled equals to disabled, so we cannot choose it again. But there's another problem here. We cannot choose it, but it doesn't start in there. So it becomes a little bit strange, doesn't it? What we do to fix it, we put selected equals to true. So it will always start choose, but we cannot come back to it. Now we are going to our radio input. The radio input, I will just remove the ID to become easier and faster. In the radio, let's put H. Save it, and here we can see already dots. Let me just BR this one and put just another BR so it gets easier to understand. In the H, we should put like 0 to 19. If he has 0 years old, he wouldn't be using the computer, but doesn't matter. Here we can click and we can actually select an option. Now we put 20 to 40, and here we go. As we have the same name, we cannot change the same option. Why? Because if we want to get only one age, one of the both, one of the two ages, the age interval that we have here, we only can get one value. The value, he can be young, and he can be old. So now, if we click in here, we are going to send young. If we are clicking here, we are going to send old. But if we remove the name, as I told you, you can select both options. You don't want that. You just want only one, as I explained. Now, for the Last one, for the food, we are going to use the checkbox, sorry, input, checkbox. And there we go, you can see the checkbox is already working. We must put something like radio, pizza, BR, so it goes down. Chocolate and McDonald's. Here we go. You have the three checkboxes. Checkboxes are completely different from radio, because radio is made to only accept one value, when checkboxes are made to accept multiple values. So we are going to put the same name in all of them. Name is equal to food, copy it and paste it, and we can still manage it. But now I will teach you a trick. If you want to receive multiple values in PHP, for example, you probably can want, you may want to put these two little things, these two straight brackets, I don't know if it is the name, the right name, but to say that it is an array. Sometimes you may want to do it. Now, lastly, to prevent errors in both checkboxes and radios, you may want to put in the first option the checked attribute. So the first one will always start checked. Ah, but why do we want it? Sometimes when you want to receive the data, it can be null and there's no problems, etc, etc. At least you may want to put one of these. In this one doesn't make any sense. But imagine in language you may want to put at least the English. If you are doing a form in English, the person reading it should know English. So, for this tutorial is everything. Hope you guys enjoyed and see you soon.